everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Lalita and today in this video I am going to discuss about frequency modulator and its order code is 2223UN0175.49. With the help of this frequency modulator, the frequency of the information wave is added with the carrier wave. Because of this, the frequency of the information wave is increased and this is widely used in FM radio broadcasting. Now I am going to giving you an overview of this apparatus. In this apparatus, we have different block for the benefit of users. First block we have sine generator, then VCO modulator block, reactance modulator block, varector modulator block, mixer amplifier block, amplitude limiter block, PLL detector 1 block, detuned resonator block, PLL detector 2 block, low pass filter block, quadrature detector block, ratio foster safety block. Now we will start the experiment one by one. Now we will start the experiment to study of frequency modulation using varector modulator. First of all, we will connect the apparatus to the AC supply. After that, I will make the connection according to this block diagram. So let's start to make the connections. First of all, the sine out of sine generator will connect to the varector modulator in. After that, we will connect the varector modulator out to mixer in. And then we will connect the sine out to the channel 1. And then we will connect the channel 2 to out of mixer and put the switch on of the apparatus. You can see on the display of TSO the output. This is the audio frequency sine wave which will be used as our modulating signal. Now we will start the second number experiment. Now I am going to do second number experiment to study of frequency modulation using reactance modulator. We will make the connections according to this block diagram. Let's start to make the connections. First of all, the sine out of sine generator will connect to the varector modulator in. After that, we will connect the out of varector modulator to the mixer amplifier. Then we will connect the out of mixer to the in of detuned resonator. And then we will connect the out of detuned resonator to the low pass filter in. After that, we will connect the CRO channel 1 to sine out. And then channel 2 will connect the out of low pass filter. Then put the switch on. We measure the result through the DSO. You can measure the output through the DSO. These are the signals we are getting through this experiment. We will continue the second number experiment and will make the connections according to this block diagram. So let's start to make the connections. First of all, I will connect the sign out to the in off vector modulator. And then we'll connect the out of in vector modulator out to mixer amplifier in. And then we'll connect the out of mixer amplifier to in of amplifier limiter. After that, we will connect the out of amplitude limiter to the detuned resonator. And then we will connect the out of detuned resonator to the PLL detector 2. After that, we will connect the CRO channel 1 to sign out. Channel 1 to sign out. And we will connect the CRO channel 2 to out of PLL detector 2. Switch on of the apparatus. You can see on the display of DSO, this is the result. Now we will start the experiment 3rd to study of operation of detuned resonant circuit. We will make the connections according to this block diagram. Let's start to make the connections. First of all, I will connect the sign generator sign out to the in off vector modulator. And then we will connect the out of vector modulator to mixer amplifier in. After that, we will connect the out of mixer amplifier to in off quadrature detector. After that, we will connect the in of low pass filter to out of quadrature detector. After that, we will connect the CRO channel 1 to sign out. And CRO channel 2 will connect the out of low pass filter. And connect the ground here. Put the switch on of power. You can see the output through the display. These are the waveforms which we are getting. Now we will start the experiment number 4 to study of operation of quadrature detector, and we will make the connections according to this block diagram. So let's start to make the connections. First of all, I will connect the sign out of sign generator to in of vector modulator. After that, I will connect the out of varactor modulator to in of mixture limiter. And then we will connect the out of mixer amplifier to the in of PLL detector. And then we will connect the out of PLL detector to low pass filter in. Then we will connect the CRO channel 1 to sign out. And then CRO channel 2 out of low pass filter. And after that we will connect the ground. And we will switch on to the apparatus. We will measure the output through the DSO. You can see the result on the DSO. These are the signals we are getting. Now we will continue the next experiment to study of operation of Foster sleepy detector, and we will make the connections according to this block diagram. So let's start to make the connections. First of all, I will connect the sign generator sign out to the in of varactor modulator. After that, I will connect the varactor modulator out to the mixture amplifier in. And then we will connect the out of mixture amplifier to in of ratio Foster sleepy. And then we'll connect the ratio out to the in of low pass filter. And then we will connect the CRO channel 1 to sign out. And then CRO channel 2 will connect the out of low pass filter. Put the switch on and we will measure the output through the DSO display. This is the signal which we are getting through this experiment. You can see on the display of DSO. Now we will start the next experiment to study of operation of ratio detector, and we will make the connections according to this block diagram. So let's start to make the connections. First of all, I will connect the sign out to in of VCO modulator. And we'll connect the VCO modulator out to in of detuned resonator. And we will connect the CRO channel 1 to sign out. And we'll connect the ground here. After that, we will connect the out of CRO channel 2 detuned resonator. and we will switch on. You can measure the output through the CRO. This is the result we are getting through this experiment. So that's all the demonstration which is given by me. If you have any query related to this apparatus, you can go through the link which is given in the description. And if you want to know more about this apparatus, you can go through the lab manuals. Thanks for watching this video. If you like it, please like, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you.